Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we'll explore how to use the Curve on Surface command to modify advanced surface faces. This tool allows you to create surface splines, lines, arcs, and circles directly on surface geometry. We are going to start with this curved sheet body, and our goal is to create a complex shape that follows its contour. To begin, we can navigate to the Curve tab, and we will find the Curve on Surface command under the Advanced group. For today's work, I'm going to create two circles of different sizes, connect them with splines, and use the thicken command to produce a body from our new shape. Starting off with the arc circle option, we first need to select the face or faces we want to work on. From there, the next section of the command window allows us to decide the curve creation mode we will use. The projection mode will project curves along the local surface normals, while the geodesic mode minimizes arc length. Next, we can select our center point and define the radius of our circles. For the first circle, I'll set the radius to 50 millimeters, and for the second circle, we can do 80. Next, I would like to connect our circles with splines on both sides. We'll continue using the Curve on Surface command, and this time we can snap our new points to the existing circles. As we select each point, we can choose the continuity options. Additionally, if we right-click on our points after they have been placed, we can control the tangent magnitudes for each curve. As we wrap up our surface design, we can next look to the changes we can make to transform this geometry into a 3D body that will match the surface contour of our sheet. One useful command that can do this is the Thicken tool located under the Surface tab within the base group. This command creates a solid body by adding thickness to selected faces. We are prompted to select the desired face of our sheet body and the boundary curves we just created, and we can quickly produce our new body. Before we finish, let's look at how we can dynamically update our curves and see the changes in real time for our new body. To do this, we can select an existing curve, navigate to Details, and right-click on Expression. From there, if we choose Step Expression, we can use the slider to dynamically adjust our model to meet our design requirements. In conclusion, in this video, we've explored some of the basics of using Curve on Surface to create geometry on advanced surfaces. We started by exploring the arc and circle options, producing two circles on the curve sheet. Next, we connected the circles with splines, utilizing continuity and tangency options to refine their shapes. And finally, we applied the thicken command to transform our geometry into a 3D body and explored the step expression option and its dynamic update capabilities. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.